everyone, welcome to our marine knowledge channel. This is Sailor Basha. If you are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and do not forget to click bell icon so that you will get notification of any of our future videos which will be uploaded in our channel. So today we are going to see about deck tour. What are all the machineries kept in the deck, and how a ship deck looks like. All this thing I am going to show it and try to explain whichever information I know. So we are now in UK Anchorage, and weather is also good. Time is now almost 8 o'clock. You can see sun is still there. Oh, please continue watching the video. Let's go inside the video. Okay, so now I am standing on top of a pollard. So this is your forward station, this is your forecastle of a ship. Okay, so this is our forward portion of the ship, and this is where I am standing on top of a pollard. Okay, so always try to walk on deck with your helmet on your head, and that too when you are in a container ship. It is better to always wear your safety helmet and walk on deck, because sometimes this container just locks, some securing arrangement, anything can fall. So better be safe. Okay, so this is your pollard. You can see the pollard over here. This you call it as pollards, and you can see the SWL written on the pollard top. You can see this is the safe weight load for this pollard, 75 ton. That means this pollard can take a capacity, take a load of 75 tons. And here you can see rollers over here. This is your roller. You can see roller. From here you can see the water also. You can see the water. Your water. And the reason why they kept the roller here is this is your mooring winch. This you call it as mooring winch. And whenever ship go alongside, whenever ship goes to port, so we need to tie the ship towards the port side. So what they do, they will be tying the ship with this rope. You can see the rope. So for lowering the rope, we use a motor to rotate this machine. This you call it as mooring winch. This mooring winch is used to heave up and lower the mooring ropes. So this rope will be passing through this way, these rollers. So while passing this rope, this roller will helps to move the rope freely. So whenever you are passing the rope to tug, or you are trying make fasting the ship, so this rollers will help you to move the to pass the rope easier. So these two we call it as mooring winch. And you can see we have almost 1, 2, 3 mooring winch in the forward station. So this you call it as forward station. So this is your forward mast, and you can see a camera over here. Since this vessel is a big ship, and captain cannot able to see the forward station when the vessel is fully loaded. You can see now the vessel is fully loaded. And if the master or the pilot who want to see what is happening in the forward station, he cannot get a vision of what is happening in this area. So we have a camera over here, and he can monitor what all the things happening in the forward station. And this is your operating panel for your mooring winch. So you got the 3 mooring winch, and for all the 3 we have 3 individual operation panel. can see here heave in and pay out. That means if you operate this way, you can heave in, and if you pay do the other way, you can pay out. That means you are lowering the rope, or you can heave up the rope. You can see over here. Yeah, you can see this is your panel for your mooring winch, and you can see all indication whether this is for the stop, and this is for indication whether is power is on or not. This light will glow if there is any alarm, and this is for your emergency stop, and this will show you whether the mooring winch is getting overloaded or something. Okay, so we have three, and for all the three we have three individual. Okay, this is actually a watertight panel, so you have to keep it always closed all the time. Even if any rainwater comes, that rainwater don't get inside the panel. So next will be our wind loss. This is your wind loss, and we have two wind loss. Wind loss means this can lower the anchor, and lower the anchor or heave up the anchor. Like this, you call it as mooring winch. That will be used for lowering your mooring ropes or heaving up the ropes. Same like that, if it is used for your anchor lowering, we call this as windlass. It's a very huge windlass, because since the weight of the anchor is very heavy, they are given a very big windlass, and you can see the size of the anchor chain. This is the size of the anchor chain. It is very huge, massive anchors. And you can see, this is how the anchor goes down. This is what you call it as hose pipe, and the anchor chain will go down this way, and anchor will be hanged on the outside of our forward hull. So okay, so we have two. One is port side anchor windlass, the other is starboard side anchor windlass. Two anchor windlass, one over here and one over here. And here is our bosun store. If you want to lift anything from the bosun store, you just need to open it, lift it up, and this is your crane, a small crane which is operated by your crane. You can say it's a winch David. So this is operated by air. So if you want to lift any drums, any ropes, you can use this. It got a minimum safe weight. It's very minimum load we can lift it, 0.2. That's 200 kilo you can lift it using this crane. So this is also secured. Okay, so what are the other things which we see in the forward station? Okay. This is your natural vent for our bosun store. I already told you what is the purpose of vents. Vent is used to remove any gases inside the stores. And you got a life buoy in the forward station. So if any emergency, someone fall down, just throw it, and they will use for recovering, and they will use it as a born again. We had a life buoy over here. You can see, and this is connected to a SAT. So the reason why they kept in the forward station is if anyone fall overboard for any reason accidentally, so if someone saw it, any of the crew fall down, and the other crew saw that he fallen down, so what you do is immediately pick the life buoy and throw overboard, so that the position where the crew fall down will be identified, and the crew who fall down can use this life buoy and save himself. And the requirement for this life buoy is you need to get your ship names and registration to be marked, and you need to have a grab rope, and here you got attention with a SAT, and the diameter for this is usually 400, and OD will be 800 mm. So this is some additional information, and that should be a reflector tape for all the live boys, so that even during night time, if someone saw this, they can easily identify the live boy. Okay, so these are all the things that you can find in the forward station, forward part of the ship. Okay, so now we'll go to the bosun store. Okay. This is bosun store. This is in most of the ship, bosun store will be always in the forward side of the ship. So you can see here aboard, restricted personnel only, and more important thing is to be closed at sea. So the reason why they kept a note over here that we need to close the door at sea, because during sea passage sometimes the weather will get bad. So what happens is the water will start flashing up, and there are chances for seawater to come inside. So if the door is kept open, the seawater may get inside the stores. So that is the reason that we need to keep this door always shut at sea. Okay, so I'm going to enter the bosun store. Okay, so it's a lock, so do not forget to put a safety latch. It's on. Okay, go inside. And this is your bosun store exhaust fan. So before entering, you just switch on the fan. So the reason for switching on the bosun store exhaust fan is because any gases, in case if any gas were present inside the store, that will be removed, because all the time this door is closed. So before entering the store, it's better to ventilate the bosun store. Okay, so go and check. Here, since this ship is a very big ship, the bosun store size is also very huge. Here, in this store, they keep all kinds of ropes, mooring ropes, and your cargo latching materials, and ladders, all these shovels, vent filters, some empty drums. They will try to keep everything which is used on deck, like ropes, cleaning materials, and the wires. And all these things they use to secure it. And you can see the cargo lasers, all this door, all this. See this twist lock over here. It's automatic lock. This is your lashing. I told about this lashing in my last video also, and you can see this is your anchor chain T-shirt. You can see the size of it. Okay, and this is what you can find things in bosun store. And you can see a locker over here. You can see two lockers over here. These two locker, we call it as chain lockers. In this locker, you can see anchor chains. Anchor chain will be secured in these two lockers. So, and okay, I'll go there. This door, if you open it, you can see the anchor chains
and they can find whether everything is normal, whether there is any water inside the tank. All these things you can check if you open this door and see.
Now we are done with our what are the things that you can machineries that you can find in the forward station, forward portion of the ship, and what will be there inside the bosun store. And okay, now we start walking on the deck. So again, deck here also you can find a mooring winch. Reason they have kept mooring winch here is because since it's a big ship, it needs a lot of ropes to be tied to keep secure when it is at port. So there is one more winch over here, and you can see the fire hose box. So you can find this fire hose box almost in every cargo hold. So if you open this box, you can see the fire hose and nozzle and. So this is your fire hydrant valve. So whenever there is any emergency, like if there is any need of doing a firefighting, just you need to start the fire pump, rig the hose, connect it to the fire hydrant, and you can start doing the firefighting. So you can find this hydrant and hose in every cargo hold of this ship. And for each and every cargo hold, you will be finding a vent. So for all the cargo hold, both port side and starboard side, you will be finding a vents, which will be two types. One will be a natural vent and one will be a forced vent, which is operated. We can just start the fan and it will do the ventilation. Okay, so this is that vent fan. So you can see the containers over here. Now how many containers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, 7 high containers. And if you go behind, you can see the containers loaded till 11, 12 high. It depends on the loading plan. They used to load the container. Usually forward side, they will try to keep minimum containers because in order to get an aerodynamic effect, they try to make a loading plan in a curvature way. Okay, so you can see this is your green color mark. So you just need to walk in this way. Okay, and you can see this is your vent for all the tanks. This is your vent for all the ballast tanks. So each and every cargo hold bottom will be having some tank. This ship they got lot of water ballast tanks. So each and every tanks has a vent. I had already in my previous video I had shown what is the purpose of vent. So you can watch that video to know what is the purpose of these vents. Okay, then again forward station you'll be having a life raft. So this is also for an emergency purpose, like if people working on deck, if at any reason if any emergency comes up that we need to abandon the ship, then what they do is they will launch this life raft and get inside the life raft and save themselves. And again procedure for launching the life raft is sticked over here. Just follow the procedure which is given by the maker. So you can launch it, and you can see the procedure over here also. And this is your life raft symbol, and this indicates the number of person that life raft can accommodate. Okay, so you can see over here, you can see over here indication. So the reason why they kept is, so when you launch the life raft, and this is your ladder, this is your ladder, we already covered it. So you have to put the ladder down, and you have to get down via ladder, and you can use the life raft and save yourself. So these are all the things why they kept one life raft, the ladder, and your area where you are going to fit your ladder. This is your ladder securing arrangement, you can see. Just D-shackles, all will be inside, readily available in the ladder. You just need to rig it and lash it, throw the life raft, and you can save yourself. Okay. We are now in Anchorage, UK Anchorage. So the weather is also very nice. Sea is also very calm. No rough weather, no much wind and everything. So good. As I told earlier, each and every cargo hold will be having a fire hose box and fire hydrants. And all over the deck you'll be having the lights, and these are all the ladders to climb up, and you can reach the cargo hold. This is your cargo and if you climb up you can see the cargo hold hatch cover. I had shown that hatch cover also earlier in my videos. And if you want to go in the bay between two container bays, you can use this ladder, go inside, and you can go up. The reason why you need to go up is for you need to check the lashing, container lashing, every day. So that for checking the lashing you have to climb up. So this is how they climb and go walkway. They have 2-3 heights over there. You can go and check your lashings. This is your bin. This bin is kept almost every alternate cargo hold. So this they keep all the container lashing materials. You can see some lashing material over here. Some lashing material they keep. So usually before at port they use this mostly, and to secure any lashing materials they use this bin. And this is your airline over here. So the reason why they kept airline on deck is if you need to do any maintenance work on deck, suppose you want to do any buffing, you need to remove any old paints, any rust, so you can use the air and use your buffing machine, chipping gun, whatever, and do the maintenance work on deck. Yeah, this is what you call it as capstan. Suppose when you are taking any bunker, if any boat is coming alongside with you and you want to tie the boat along with our boat. So they use this capstan to take the rope from the next boat. So all you do is just open and just lever, you can see the lever. Yeah, this is how it operates. This you call it as capstan. This is operated by air. So again, for this also you can see the safe weight load given. Okay. And here you can see the water connection. So the reason why they kept a water connection on deck is if they do any deck wash, if they want to do the deck washing by fresh water, they use this water connection. And you can see this is what you call it as
scupper plug.
Carry. Okay. This is what you call it as scupper plug. The reason why they give the scupper plug is if there is any for in case accidentally if any oil spill happened, so the oil should not go overboard. And sometimes in ports they don't allow any wash water to go overboard. So if you fit the scupper plug, the water or oil whichever inside the ship won't go overboard. If you remove the plug, you just need to loosen it and remove it. You can see here. So this is directly connected to your ship overboard. So for you should always ensure this rubber is in a good condition. If not, it don't do the sealing properly. So when you want to fit it back, just fit it and tight it. That's all. So you have this copper plug almost everywhere in the deck. So if you are doing any washing and all, you just need to remove it, open it and finish it off. Your water will go overboard. So, whatever you see in the starboard side, the same you can find it on the port side also. That is, there won't be any difference. Whatever you see here, you will see on the starboard side. So this is your hand railing for holding when you are walking or during any rough weather. If you are walking on deck, you just need to hold this hand rail and you can walk safely. Now we go to the accommodation and we will see what are all the machineries which is kept in the accommodation. Go to the accommodation side so that you can see what are all the machineries which is kept in the accommodation area. Here you can see there is a lifeboat over here, and this lifeboat is basically if there is any emergency, if it comes on board, like for some reason we need to abandon ship, so we can use the lifeboat to save our life. That is the reason we have a lifeboat over here, and we'll be having lifeboat on both the side of the ship, both the starboard side and port side. And whatever equipments you see in the port side, that same equipment you will find in the starboard side also. Okay, this is your lifeboat. And next video, maybe I will try to show what are all the things that lifeboat have. Now, and this is your life raft. Same. The purpose of the life raft is also same. The life saving only. So this life raft, we can launch it by manually, or we can by itself it launches, because when the ship sinks and at some pressure the life raft will get cut and it will expand. It is like it will become like a boat. So this is your life raft and this is your high boat. You can see there is a, you can see this is the top portion of your lifeboat, and I think for, you can see the capacity and everything written. This lifeboat can handle 35 persons, and yeah, these are the lifeboat crane. Like this is your winch for lowering your lifeboat. These two crane like thing we used for lowering our lifeboat in case of any emergency. And you can see some life jacket and immersion suits kept on board. Here you can see some lifeboat, life jacket and immersion shoe. It's for emergency, you can use it. Launching procedures for this knife raft over here. So you just need to follow the procedure given here, and I will put on my next video about how to launch the knife raft and how to launch the lifeboat. Also, you can see launching procedure over here also, how to launch your knife raft, and you can see the procedure for how to launch your lifeboat. So you just need to follow the procedure which is given in your instruction. So you launch your lifeboat or life raft, whichever you want. Here, you can see this is your death workshop, and there's a lot of things, all repair equipments, ropes, lathe, some spanner tools, everything will be there. And before entering your accommodation, you can see a fire plan over here. So this fire plan contains the entire ship firefighting plan and everything. It has a paper inside it. It got a fire plan fully. So the reason for keeping this fire plan is if any person, any outside people who come for rescuing or for firefighting, so they cannot go inside and check for the firefighting manual and look for the fire plan. So when they enter inside only, they just need to open it and open. And you can see the paper. So this is all your fire plan. This is how the fire plan will be. So any shore party who comes for doing firefighting can easily pick up the fire plan of our ship, and they can do the rescue operation or firefighting operation. So this is why they kept a fire plan. And this fire plan, you can find it on both the side, both port side and starboard side. Usually
all ships will be having accommodation and engine room on the same deck. But this ship, since it's a big ship, so we have accommodation and engine room separately. Accommodation will be in the forward and engine room will be in the aft. So this is your engine room area and this is your bunker station. Bunker station is nothing, it is like taking petrol for our car. So usually for car you go to the petrol bunk and fill. But here what we do is, this is your pipe which is connected to the tanks, which is your fuel oil tank which we use to run our generator. So when the we used to take a lot of bunkers, we will take in tons. So that will be taken from the small boats. So that boat will give us a hose, and that hose will be connected to this pipe, and then we do the bunker. Bunker means we take fuel from the boat for our requirement. So here you can see lot of pipe. So each and every pipe is connected to different tanks. So suppose this pipe is for diesel oil, this pipe is for heavy oil, this pipe is for sludge, this pipe is for bilge, this pipe is for lube oil. So each and every pipe will go to individual tank is mentioned on top of it. So this is our bunker station and this is a small crane. It's a small Corydus David crane and bunker David. So this we use to lift the force which is provided by the bunker supplier from the boat. From the other boat we lift the hose through this crane. can see something called emergency exit. So this indicates when there is any emergency, like if there is any emergency in the engine room, so we have a emergency exit so that we can come out of the engine room in case of any fire or anything. So when we use that emergency door, and that door will lead to this exit. So that is the reason they marked, highlighted over here, emergency exit. Very nice, very nice. All mountains and everything. It's sunny. It is 8 o'clock, 8:30. You can see the sun is still shining. Long days. Again, a capstan over here. The same reason I told why we have a capstan. We are on the aft part of the ship. So from here you can see the other end of the ship also. You can see the breadth of the ship. It's it got a big breadth, maybe 60 meter breadth of the ship. Okay, we'll go down. So this is your aft part of the ship. Again, you can see a roller over here, roller over here. And one thing I wanted to tell you, you can see a marking called snapback zone. So the reason why they marked it as a snapback zone, because when the vessel is tied, the rope will be strongly secured with our port bollard and our mooring wheel. Something what happens, if it is getting more load, the rope tends to break. So if it breaks, it will hit very hardly. So if someone is standing in that area, it can even damage their body, their leg or whatever. So always they say you cannot stand in the snapback zone area. So again, there is a pullout over here, mooring winch, an aft station. We have around 5 mooring winch in the aft station. And again, for each and every mooring winch, we have a operating panel over here. For each and every mooring winch, we have a operating panel. You can see here, this is the operating panel for it. And that's all for here. For today, we have completed our deck round. I believe this video must have given you some information about what are all the things you can find on deck on a container ship. So whatever I know, I had given you as a information and as a video. Please put your comments if you have any doubts on this video. I will definitely reply you. And if you like this video, please like, share, and do not forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching. Thank you all.